It's very important to the process of understanding Google Cloud and passing the certification exam that you go through the question and attempt answering it yourself first. So pause the video, work through the question. We'll catch up in just a little while and I'll show you how I do it. This project scenario is based on the TerramEarth case study. You analyzed TerramEarth's business requirement to reduce downtime and found that they can achieve a majority of time saving by reducing customers' wait time for parts. You decide to focus on reduction of the 3 weeks aggregate reporting time. Which modifications to the company's processes should you recommend? So, in this project scenario, you have been called in as an architect. You have evaluated the current process and noticed that there is a 3 weeks reporting time before the data goes from these vehicles to the backend system and comes back to the technicians. We want to now reduce this 3 weeks reporting time. What modifications should we suggest to the company's processes? Let's look at option A. Option A suggests that we migrate from CSV to binary, we migrate from FTP to SFTP transport, and develop machine learning analysis of metrics. There are three parts to this, so let's look at them one by one and see if some of them are suitable and some are not. How about machine learning analysis? In this case, we have a large amount of data. If we set aside a lot of effort to find out business rules, to figure out which are the systems or which are the parts that are going to have a problem and they need to be stocked in advance or they need to be updated or renewed quickly, those business rules or creating those business rules is going to take an inordinately amount of time. Not only that, to manage them is going to be very unwieldy. We are going to have to do this very regularly and keep testing it against what is happening in the field. Therefore, in working with such large amounts of data and trying to come up with rules that get us a particular result, instead of trying to identify business rules manually, it is a much better option to take a machine learning approach to this. So the option of choosing machine learning analysis of the metrics is, in my opinion, a very positive step. How about the remaining two? In changing from CSV to binary format, we might achieve some compression, and maybe the compressed data will reach the server slightly quicker. But it is not going to have a significant impact on the 3 weeks reporting time, because this data is going to take a long time to reach the backend servers as and when the vehicles come in, you pull out the data and then upload it. So the fact that we improve the compression a bit is not going to have any impact on the 3 weeks aggregate reporting time. How about FTP to SFTP transport change? Doing this might increase the security of the transfer, but again, the data is only going to come in when it comes in, which is late, and then it needs to be uploaded. So this again is going to have no significant impact on the reporting time, which is currently 3 weeks. So neither the CSV to binary change nor the FTP to SFTP change suggestion is going to have any impact on this process, and therefore option A has to be eliminated. How about option B? Option B suggests that we migrate from FTP to streaming transport, migrate from CSV to binary format, and develop machine learning analysis of metrics. We already saw that using machine learning for this option is a good idea. So we have a tick here. CSV to binary is not going to make a big impact, but if the others worked better than what was previously, this could have a slightly reasonable impact in the sense that we are now using a binary format which could be a little compressed. The first part of the suggestion is that we shift from my FTP transport to streaming transport. This is a great option. This means that we can have this data almost in real time. If these vehicles were able to transmit the data as soon as it generated those events, that would be great. So if we were able to change from FTP to streaming transport, we will have the data at the backend servers quickly, and we will be able to therefore reduce the aggregate reporting time also. So we've got a couple of ticks here, and even though CSV to binary format is weak, overall, I think B has some good options. Therefore, we're going to bank this option, and we're going to come back to it in case there aren't better options in the remaining ones that we have. Option C suggests that we increase fleet cellular connectivity to 80%, migrate from FTP to streaming transport, and develop machine learning analysis of metrics. So we already saw that machine learning is a good option to have. FTP to streaming, also a good option to have, because then we don't need to wait for these vehicles to come in and the data to be uploaded in batch. It can just be uploaded as soon as those events are generated. So both the options for FTP streaming, from FTP to streaming and to use machine learning for this are great options. How about the first part of the option, which is to increase fleet cellular connectivity to 80%? This is brilliant. As of now, the number of machines that are connected are very low. If you look at the case study, a large number of machines are still offline. Even without knowing that, this option suggests that we increase fleet cellular connectivity to 80%, which indicates that it must be less than 80% right now. So the more machines we can get directly connected to the backend server, streaming data in, we will have much quicker reports that we can generate. So the faster data gets in, the faster we are able to generate the reports. So this gives me a tick on all three options, and this has a specific option to increase cellular connectivity for the fleet, which is again a very useful option to reduce the 3 weeks aggregate reporting time. So for me, this is becoming a strong yes. How about option D? Option D suggests that we migrate from FTP to SFTP, we develop machine learning analysis of the metrics, and increase dealer local inventory. Well, we already saw FTP to SFTP has no impact on reporting time, a slight improvement in the security aspect of the data transfer, but as such, it's not going to change our 3 weeks reporting time. Machine learning is good to have, but increasing the local inventory at the dealers who is near the customer site is going to have no impact on the reporting time, because what we care about is the machines that are already in the field, the vehicles that are already in the field. Those need to be reporting data quickly back to the backend server. By increasing the vehicles that are there at the local inventory, is not going to change anything for these vehicles on the field. Therefore, option D is not useful for us, and we are going to eliminate option D. Given that, we had a couple of options that were close to the right answer. But among that, migrating from CSV to binary didn't have a significant impact, whereas increasing the fleet cellular connectivity to 80% will have a significant impact. Looking at the case study itself, you can see that TerramEarth today has about 20 million vehicles in operation. Within that, only about 200,000 vehicles are connected via the cellular network. That's only about 1% of the total number of vehicles. Therefore, the option to increase the cellular connectivity of the fleet to 80% is definitely our best option, and therefore we go with option C. Well, how are you going to inform others of this super GCP content? Just one way: like it, share it, let them get to know of it, and you subscribe.